Assalamualaikum and a very good morning to all of you. Students, today we will start our geography third chapter, that is minerals and power resources. Now children, what do you understand by minerals? Now minerals are naturally occurred substance that has a definite chemical composition which is called as a minerals, right? Now minerals are not evenly distributed over a space, means they are not evenly distributed, means they are not evenly, we will not find evenly at all in each and every places, right? Means we find some minerals at some places and some mineral at other places, right? Each and every minerals are not found at a very same place. They are concentrated in a particular area or a rock formation. They are either in the concentration form or either in a rock formation. They depends on the mineral itself, right? Some minerals are found in the areas which are not easily accessible. They are not easily accessible means some minerals we find at some places, for example, Arctic Ocean and Antarctica. Here, this Arctic Ocean and Antarctica, we see that they are at a frigid zone. Yes, the snow is more, right? So here people are not much more accessible. So these minerals are found on these places also where the people are not able to access, right? Now minerals are found in different types of a geological environments under the varying condition. Now minerals, as we all know that minerals are of a different types of a geological environment. They are found in a geological environments, different environments, different places we find these minerals, and under varying condition they are found in a different types of a condition, different positions they are found. They are created by the natural process without any human interference. Now these minerals which they form are not human made, means there is not at all any human interference in it. That is why they are called as a natural process. Now these minerals are also called as a natural process. That is why we always say that minerals are created by natural process without any human interference. Now they can be identified on the basis of their physical properties such as color, their density, hardness and chemical property such as solubility, right? Now yes, we all know that all the minerals have different types of color, different type of size, shape. Yes, their hardness also depends on mineral to mineral. Yes, again they have a different types of a chemical properties also, such as they are soluble or insoluble, right? Now children, we will see the types of minerals. As we all know that we have two main basic types of minerals. One is metallic and another is non-metallic. Again, in metallic we have two types of metallic minerals, that is ferrous and another is non-ferrous, right? Now what is metallic minerals? Minerals which contains metal in raw form. Yes, we found it in a raw form. Then metals are hard substance that conduct heat as well as electricity and have a characteristic to luster, that is they are shiny, they shine. Yes, so these are the properties of a metal. We see n number of metals, like we have utensils at our places, we have iron vehicles. Yes, those metals are of those ions. Yes, bauxite, manganese, ore are some of the example. Yes, these are the things which we have, the utensils which we use in our house, the vehicles which we drive, those metals which we which are used in a vehicles, they have a luster, they have a shiny substance, right? So these are the metallic forms. Now metallic minerals may be ferrous and non-ferrous. We will see that what is ferrous. Ferrous minerals like iron ore, manganese and chromites contains iron. Now these minerals, they contain iron, that is why they are called as a ferrous. And the minerals which does not contain iron are called as a non-ferrous minerals. right? Now these non-ferrous minerals are such as gold, silver, copper or lead. Yes. Now non-metallic minerals, we will see non-metallic minerals do not contain metals, right? Limestone, mica and gypsum are the examples of such minerals. The mineral fuel like coal and petroleum are also non-metallic minerals. Children, so now we will define minerals can be seen. They are extracted. Minerals are extracted by either mining, either drilling or either quarrying, right? Now we will see how the minerals are extracted below the earth, from the earth, right? By mining, we have again two different methods, that is open cast mining and shaft mining, right? Now the process of taking out minerals from the rock buried under the earth surface is called as a mining, right? Now this whole process which we take out from the rocks buried under the earth, the rocks that we have and the minerals which are taking out from this earth surface is called as a mining. I'll give you good example. We have seen n number of movies, we have seen in several times in the Discovery channels also, coal mines we are seeing. People go below the earth by lift and there they do blast and from there they extract coal and other minerals by mining method, right? Now mineral that lie at a shallow depth are taken out by removing the surface layer, means they are not so deep as compared to the coal mines, right? They are on the upper layer of the earth surface, you can say. They are not so deep, it has a shallow depth, are taken out by removing the surface layer. This is known as a open cast mining. Now deep bores called as a shaft. Now we have a deep bores which is also called as a shaft. Have to be made to reach mineral deposit that lie at a great depth. Now this is called as a shaft mining. Petroleum and natural gas occur far below the earth surface. Deep well are the bore to take them out. Now this is called as a drilling. See here, you will see in your picture on page number 25, offshore drilling of the oil. Right. We have, for example, Bombay High, you must have seen, it is in the Arabian Sea near Mumbai, right? There this has a drilling, offshore drilling of oil. The petroleum which is there in the ocean, below the ocean, from there this drilling is done and from there we abstract the petroleum. Yes, mineral that lie near the surface are simply dug out by the process that is known as a quarrying. Now quarrying is a mineral that lie near the surface, which is near the surface are simply dug, which is not below, which is not very deep, that is called as a, which is simply dug out, and by that process which is known as a quarry. Okay, children, now we will see another topic tomorrow. By the time, look at these topics, that is minerals and different types of minerals and how the extraction of mineral is done, that is mining, drilling and quarry. Go through the textbook and write it down in your notebook. That is mineral, the flowchart of the mineral. This you are supposed to draw in your notebook, as well as this one, that is extraction of a minerals. This you will have to draw. This flowchart you are supposed to draw in your notebook. Okay? We will see you tomorrow. Thank you. Have a nice day.